We're Duncan. My name's Leah.
I'm Olive.
I'm Erin.
I'm Nick.
I'm Allie.
Okay, this is the founder of Dunkin' Donuts, William Rosenberg. And during World War II, he worked at a factory, and he decided to start selling food and drinks to the workers there. And he found that the most popular items were donuts and coffee, so he opened up his first donut coffee shop in Princeton, Massachusetts in 1948. 2 years later, in 1950, he renamed Open Kettle to Dunkin' Donuts. And in 1955, Dunkin' Donuts opened up their first franchise. And in 1963, Robert Rosenberg, who was William Rosenberg's son, took over management of the company. And under his leadership, he introduced new items to the menu, such as the Munchkin Donut Holes in 1972. And in 2006, they began their America Runs on Dunkin' marketing campaign. And in 2020, it was purchased by Inspire Brands and underwent a name change to just simply Dunkin'. And now in 2023, there are more than 13,200 restaurants in nearly 40 global markets.
So for environmental analysis, our competitive forces, we compete against the likes of Starbucks and McDonald's for morning coffee indexes. The economic forces that we see in expanding our per capita income, changing societies, and inflation, as everybody knows, in today's society is terrible. Technological forces, we use the app to enhance everybody's use of food, to enhance experiences that you use to get your food best. Social-cultural forces are things like shift towards health, so everybody wants healthier breakfasts and things of that nature. Global international forces are going to be our regulations for imports and changing societies and growing GDP.
So as Nick just said, one of our biggest competitors is Starbucks. They are very much more focused on the aesthetic and having a good quality experience, like inside the store especially, and having good quality ingredients, while Dunkin' is very much more about, we are trying to get things to people affordably and convenient.
So we created a new product called Dunkin' Premium Dunkers, which is a subscription, and it gives you access to 50 plus free coffee and donuts when you subscribe. You could either subscribe monthly for $12.99 or annually for $120. And this includes free access to coffee and donuts from the hours of 5 a.m. to 10 a.m. every day. And if this does well, we will expand our hours. And we encourage to sign up for the annual subscription to gain customer loyalty. And in the long run, you will save money. This also includes the Dunkin' Rewards program, which you could find in the app currently.
Okay, so I'm going to be covering the marketing mix, which is product, price, place, and promotion. Starting off with product, the products that are included with the subscription is any coffee and donut combination, and customizing drinks is still capable. You can still customize it to how you want it. We decided to have it as any combination so that you can still pick your favorite drink and your favorite donut and enjoy them. And also included is the seasonal coffee drinks, so you can also sub in those for a coffee drink and enjoy those during the seasons. The products that are not included are teas, sandwiches, and the frozen drinks. So moving on to price, how many of you are students? Exactly, the whole room. So you all understand the financial struggles that students have. Dunkin' understands that as well, as to why we are offering 15% off of the subscription for students. And we decided to do this just because Dunkin' understands the financial tolls that students have. So offering the 15% off will definitely help bring in students from all across the U.S. Dunkin' is offering affordable prices for the subscription. The monthly price is $12.99 and the annual is $120. And if you buy the annual, you are actually saving $36 compared to buying the monthly for a year. Moving on to place, this is going to be in all participating U.S.-based stores, so anywhere in the U.S. you will be able to use this. That includes 9,532 stores that are located in the US. And lastly, we have promotion. We are offering a $0 delivery fee. So if you are not wanting to go into the store and you want it delivered, then you get a $0 delivery fee just with the subscription. You also get the limited edition and seasonal items as mentioned on the products, so you can sub that in for a coffee drink. And then you're also going to get the first month free, so you can try before you buy, as they say. And then on the ad, there's going to be a pop-up ad, so as soon as you open up the app, you're going to see the ad for the premium subscription, and you will be notified that that is there, that is available, and you can use it.
So for the SWOT analysis, so for the strengths, one of the really big things that we wanted to tap is accessibility. So we're all college students, we're all broke. It's hard. Like, sometimes you just really want a coffee, but you don't feel like going out and buying the beans and maybe even grinding them, or just buying pre-ground beans. And it's just a whole lot of work and you don't have time for it. So on your early drive into school, you can just stop by and pick up your Dunkin' Donuts. It only takes about 3 to 4 visits to pay for the monthly subscription, and that's just based off the regular monthly subscription, not even the student one, which I believe is about 2 and 3. And then convenience. It is so nice getting, like, just ordering on the app. I did it with the Munchkins. So nice. I rolled up, they handed me the order, and I was gone in less than a minute. It was so convenient, so nice. And has anybody ever, like, dropped the change outside of, like, a drive-thru? Like, you're handing it, and you have, like, the exact amount of change, and then it's just all over the drive-thru. That's not fun. So with the subscription, you don't have to worry about finding the exact amount of change or fumbling around for your card or cash or anything.
Our weakness consists of it's not international, it's only offered in the US. Products aren't healthy, so this wouldn't necessarily appeal to more health-conscious people. It's only during limited hours, and you only get to pick from a certain number of items.
And then we are looking for new loyal customers. So we do want to get those college students who just need a quick, affordable coffee subscription who will stay with us for years to come. And we are also looking at, if it goes well domestically, to expand internationally.
Our threats are competition. Other fast food restaurants do similar subscriptions and promotions, and also the failure to gain revenue.
Our marketing objectives for the promotion is expanding our market share. So I know probably a lot of people go to Starbucks because it's convenient, but you're also spending $5 every time you go on a cup of coffee. So with that being said, we'd be able to take market share from our competitors just based on the fact that they're already prepaid for the online coffee. It would boost our sales. We would have more foot traffic through the door, and if you're riding to school with your friend and they go to get their morning coffee from Dunkin', well, you might want to buy something, so that's going to bring in more traffic. Improving brand loyalty. If you're already loyal to Dunkin', well, if you already go there every day, you're going to buy the subscription because it's going to save you money overall and it's going to make you more loyal to the brand. And then enhancing customer engagement. So because it's all done through the app, you're forced to go through the app and it's going to make you more engaged with our app. So on to the segmentation. So we want to target on-the-go customers, people who leave the house early, don't want to make coffee for themselves, moms that take their kids to school, people who just don't have time. Daily coffee drinkers, it's cheaper than buying a $10 bag of coffee every week. And it saves you time and time as money. We want to target students as well. And then we also want to retain the loyalty of the people that already come in.
So like Nick said, we want to make it easily accessible, so all you have to do is either download the app or go online and just sign up with your email. It will boost our sales and our app traffic. We are going to record our performance through our sales and the number of users that sign up for this subscription. We will be getting consecutive monthly payments for both monthly and the annual subscriptions. So like he said, we want to make it affordable for our student
users and just easily accessible. And like we said, most of our revenue and performance is in the US. Up there it's 78%. So we're gonna keep this starting off in the US and not make it international because of the percent of revenue that we see currently.
So for implementation, we're looking at specifically like targeted ads, so wanting to target that younger audience, like those college students. So we can expand on that by using like our partnerships with like Ben Affleck, J-Lo, Ice Spice, all these different like celebrities who are popular and trendy, and we can make it comical so that way we get that sort of like, you can see a TikTok of an ad and it's really funny. We want to get that going. And then we also are gonna, I know we say this a lot, but the student discount we think is really, really gonna help us get this up and rolling and profitable. Because again, students are broke. And I don't know about you guys, but I also forget to cancel my subscriptions a lot of the time. So they'll just keep on renewing and they're like, oh, get renewed.